If you think of us Americans, our character as Americans, the question is, who do we take after, the Spartans or the Athenians? And it's a really good question, because I think we have a real strong Spartan strain in our society, but we also have a tremendous Athenian strain in our society. And that's what I want to talk about today. I'm going to read something again from Thucydides' History of the Peloponnesian War. If you remember, I recommended this book before, and you can see that I really actually do read it. To set the stage, this is 50, 55 years after the Battle of Thermopylae. Athens has gone on from that moment of being utterly threatened by the Persian Empire to have created its own empire. And because of its rising power, Sparta is on the brink of going to war with them. And in fact, the whole Greek world knows there's going to be a war. It's coming. And it's going to drag every city in the world into it, including all of Persia. So this will really be the first world war, the Peloponnesian War, 27 years long. And so on the eve of this war, there was a meeting held at Sparta, where all of Sparta's allies got together and they spoke. And they decided, should we go to war, should we not go to war? And the delegation from Corinth spoke and addressed the Spartans, and they described who the enemy was, the Athenians. And this is a description. And as you listen to this, think about this as it applies to our American character at its best. This is the Corinthian delegates at the Congress at Sparta. To our mind, you are quite unaware of this difference between you and the Athenians. You have never yet tried to imagine what sort of people these Athenians are, against whom you will have to fight. How much, indeed, how completely different from you. An Athenian is always an innovator, quick to form a resolution and quick at carrying it out. You, on the other hand, are good at keeping things as they are. Athenian daring will outrun its own resources. They will take risks against their better judgment and still, in the midst of danger, remain confident. If they win a victory, they follow it up at once, and if they suffer defeat, they scarcely fall back at all. As for their bodies, they regard them as expendable for their city's sake, as though they were not their own. But each man cultivates his own intelligence, again with a view to doing something notable for his city. If they aim at something and do not get it, they think that they have been deprived of what belonged to them already. Whereas if their enterprise is successful, they regard that success as nothing compared to what they will do next. Suppose they fail in some undertaking. They make good the loss immediately by setting their hopes in another direction. Of them alone, it may be said that they possess a thing almost as soon as they have begun to desire it. So quickly with them does action follow upon decision. In a word, they are by nature incapable of either living a quiet life themselves or of allowing anyone else to do so. So to me, that's kind of our American enterprise, American know-how, American go-get-em-ism at its best. But it also, under the heading of the warrior archetype, is a really interesting concept. The concept in the Marine Corps today of the strategic corporal, meaning somebody at a very low rank who is capable, as far as the Marine Corps is concerned, of making really big decisions, just taking it into his hands. Now, I'm also reminded of Moshe Dayan, the great Israeli general who really sort of formed the character of the IDF, the Israeli Defense Forces, in the early days, in the 50s. And one of the things he said, he was very much against spit and polish. He hated to see parade ground maneuvers. And in fact, if you see Israeli army people, male or female today, they look like a bunch of ragamuffins. I mean, their uniforms are unkempt. But what Moshe Dayan said was, I don't want soldiers, I want fighters. And what he meant was he wanted people, soldiers at all levels that were capable of making decisions on their own, of improvising, because they couldn't always call back to their officers in the rear. So anyway, this is the nature of the Athenian character as opposed to the Spartan character. One has been kind of disciplined from birth to hold the line, to be strong, to endure adversity, and to hang together. The other one has kind of been schooled for birth in being innovative and being creative and breaking the rules and taking the situation as it exists and making a decision in the moment. And again, we'll talk more about this as we come to a consideration of the inner war, of how you and I live our lives day to day, incorporating the warrior archetype into the way we function as artists, as mothers and fathers, and as members of our community.